Coraline rehearsal recording for The Starbird Martyr by Dvořák. Soprano. On this recording, the soprano part is represented by a flute sound. Here's a short example. That's the end of the example. But remember, you can use your stereo balance control to further enhance or diminish your own vocal line. You'll find that the accompaniment is played on the organ throughout, as are any soloist's cues, though these are on a contrasting registration. Although we hint at tempi and dynamics on this recording, we've generally kept these fairly neutral, as they'll be at the discretion of your conductor. Some editions of the score use rehearsal figures, but so as to be as universal as possible, we'll not use these, but use bar numbers instead. If your score does not show bar numbers, you may wish to pencil them in. Each movement will begin afresh with bar one. Please remember that this recording contains copyright material, and that it's illegal to allow any part of it to be copied. In places, your part splits into first and second voice parts. Generally, this is only for a few notes, so we played the two parts together as a chord. However, where the parts differ significantly, we'll play the second voice part as a separate track at the end of the appropriate movement. Here, then, is the Starbird Martyr by Dvořák. There's a long introduction to this movement, so we won't play all of it here, but go from bar 64. That's seven bars before the tenors begin with Starbird Martyr Dolorosa. You then come in at bar 85. And bar 100, and thank you. are 156. This next section is for tenor solo.
Sings, so
O Quam Tristis et Afflicta. Your entry is three bars later at bar 203. And